Consider supporting this channel for as little as $5 a month on Patreon. You can also commission future content for this game. Link is in the description. You can also send a one-time donation of any amount to this channel using PayPal. Link is in the description. This is a General Electric SEPTA Silverliner IV electric multiple unit train set. Edit the track sounds in a little bit because they're a little bit too loud and they overpower the engine sound. I'm pretty sure the driver stands up in this train because I can't imagine you'd be able to see out the window sitting down. Now, you can't move the pantograph in this train because the pantograph is this trap door that you can raise and lower for high level and low level platforms. Of course, you can also use the pantograph state driver command to have the driver control them as well. Pressing it one time will lower the trapdoor on the right-hand side of the train. Pressing it a second time will lower both of them. Pressing it a third time will lift the one on the right but keep the one on the left down. And of course, pressing it a fourth time will raise all of them. And of course, you can also control the doors. As usual, there's no sound effect that'll play because I don't know how to program that to happen. Of course, to make this work, all the train cars in the consoles have to face the same way. Because if they're not, obviously some of the trap doors will be on the wrong side. There's also a camera for every single window seat. The reason why I don't have any window seats for the passengers is because I have a hard time making it so that they're not so close to the wall that their arm just sticking out of the train. It's really hard to get their attachment points right. So instead, you get the window seat. Now, I programmed the trailer unit as an engine because there's no way to program it as a rolling stock and still allow you to control it like a locomotive. For example, it wouldn't let you use the horn if it was scripted as a rolling stock instead of an engine. As you can see, there's also a luggage rack, and I also installed fluorescent tube lights. There's a cab view on both sides of the train, so you can control it from either direction. And there are also camera views on each side as well. Thank you. obviously I have to change the acceleration or deceleration, or the passengers will all complain what a bad railway this is. Number textures are transparent and are illuminated by the light that's behind them, just like in real life. Destination signs on the front and sides. This locomotive can also have LED destination signs on the front, but they're rarely used. That spot to the left of the number board is where they would be placed. There are headlights, tail lights, and ditch lights on both sides of the locomotive and trailer unit. did I mention the interior is glow in the dark?